So let's begin. To warm up, I'm going to invite all the candidates to just introduce themselves, you know, your name, your background, your connection to PJ. And maybe one most important thing that you offer being a candidate in this election. Right? Your name, your background, connection to PJ, and the one most important thing that you offer as a candidate in this election. And then, to answer the first question that we've posed to you, what is your vision of PJ in 2030? What is your vision of PJ in 2030?
Assalamualaikum, selamat pagi. My name is Jepara Binti Jamaluddin Marina Suami Alia. I'm a candidate for N36 Pada Utama, previously known as Daman Sarah Utama before the rejuvenation. A little bit background about myself, sedikit latar belakang tentang diri saya. I was one of the counselors in MPPJ for since 2016, and also the special assistant for the reason why I talk a little bit about my background is that just want to ensure that everyone here, although that I'm a new candidate, walaupun saya adalah calon baru, tapi saya ada pengalaman kerjasama dengan komuniti di bawah dengan saya pertama. Okay, so I feel that one of the most important things that the new calon or young candidate can bring to the table is that we have our fresh voice. We might bring up some new ideas. Right now, we just need to explore to understand how the system goes. And for me, currently, I think that there are a few things that I want to change here is safety and security, keselamatan di pekerja itu, public transportation, traffic and transport, issue traffic, and also quality hidup yang lebih baik, including recreation, leisure and community facilities. Now, I hope that while serving the community, I hope that PJ can turn into a livable and sustainable city. So what I mean by that is that I hope that PJ will turn into a smart city where it is with high technology, where we can improvise our transportation, improvise our cyberways, environment protection, where we can improve our neighborhood community. I hope that while we are moving towards the technology end, at the same time, I hope we can maintain our environment. Jadi saya harap kita akan berada dalam satu keadaan di mana kita bergerak ke arah teknologi untuk memperbaiki traffic, sistem traffic kita, transportation system kita. Ya, but at the same time, kita jaga semuanya alam semuanya ini. Terima kasih. Thank you. Yeah, I think my answer will be just short and sweet because both of my colleagues already answered over of it. I just wanted to clarify my stand, of course. Most from our inherited people, we agree with local council, with local council election. And not only that, I support it, I can't stress it enough. Because everywhere I go, I keep telling the residents that how good it will be if we can have the local council election. And same as Rajiv, I believe that the mayor and the deputy mayor should also be elected and not appointed. Well, it's important because most of the times for the councillors to get elected, because actually without the election, people actually don't really know that there's this position exists. Actually many of us didn't know that, because we're not elected like I joined for MP. So I feel that if the local councillors, the mayor and deputy mayor is elected, then they will get more publicity. People also will know more of their roles and what they're supposed to do. And then you will also at the same time face more pressure to really solve the residents' issues. And currently, we can see everyone is doing their best because they are appointed.
Can I draw your attention to question 7 for both you and Amy Wei, as past councillors? Perhaps you could share with us as the final part of today's forum on how we would want to increase efficiency and perhaps reduce corrupt practices in your deputy.
Currently, for the corrupt practices, it's hard for me to comment anything because personally, I did not encounter any practices that I get to hold any evidence of, to be honest. But yeah, I can see that there are some inefficiency in delivering the service. For example, a lot of contractors when we appointed them, they cannot do or manage their job well. For that, previously what we tried to do is that when we already recognize those contractors, we are ensuring to put their name into the blacklist, and then also to keep monitoring and to make sure that when we really support other contractors, that SOP and the guidelines that we follow